Hello children, how are you all? I am Sir Sheikh Safia from Anjuman Islam's Abdul Azim Khatkate English Secondary School. I think you all are fine. And today we are going to see an interesting topic in English, that is Seven Sisters. So let us begin with our topic Seven Sisters. So children, first of all, we will see what these seven sisters want to tell us. We will see that, yes, we are the seven sisters of Northeast India, still unexplored, isolated territories to most of you and to the rest of the world. We are famous for our natural beauty, lush forest and wild animals, as well as our colorful costumes, traditional jewelry, exotic flowers and our own unique dance and music. Nature lovers have designated our whole area as one of the world's biodiversity hotspots. So now we will introduce ourselves. So children, from this you must have understood what are these seven sisters. They are no human beings. We will see who are they. Now we will see who are these seven sisters. Yes, they are the seven states of the Northeast India. And they are Arunachal Pradesh, Assam, Meghalaya, Tripura, Mizoram, Manipur and Nagaland. They are the small states of India, and at get together they form the seven sisters of Northeast India. And children, the lifestyle, the food, dressing and the natural beauty of these places are almost the same, but we are going to explore all these seven sisters one by one. So first we will move on to the first sister, that is Arunachal Pradesh. Arunachal Pradesh, in Hindi Arunachal means a place where the wind blows, and we will see about the land of winds. And again, Arunachal Pradesh, also called the land of rising sun. What Arunachal Pradesh has to tell about itself? They call me the land of the rising sun, the land of dawn-lit sun. I am Arunachal Pradesh. So let us visit, let us have a look at Arunachal Pradesh. Now we will see the natural beauty of Arunachal Pradesh. Yes, you can see the lush green mountains, the waterfall and the rising sun. It's so beautiful, isn't it? You can see these waterfalls. You can see so many things in Arunachal Pradesh. The people here, they are very much simple, hospitable, and they have their own language, and it is a nature lover's heaven. Arunachal Pradesh is full of natural beauty. We will see the people here, they are so happy, they are so beautifully dressed, and see their costumes, they are so beautiful, isn't it? It consists of a sari. You can see they have, the women have wrapped themselves in a sari. Now we will move on to the people, the food of the people in Arunachal Pradesh. Children, you must have heard the momos. You eat momos, so they are so delicious, even the veg and the non-veg. So it is the staple food of Arunachal Pradesh. The food of Arunachal Pradesh mainly consists of rice, vegetables and meat. And Arunachal Pradesh, being such a simple state, the food is very simple and delicious. The people here, they are also very simple. Now we will move on to our next sister, that is Assam. Yes, taking the name of Assam. Do you remember something? Early in the morning, your mother, your parents, what they have early in the morning? Yes, tea. The tea. Tea mostly comes from Assam. There are tea gardens in Assam. And whenever we remember tea, it is Assam. And whenever we remember Assam, tea comes to our mind. Now we will see about Assam. So, other than tea, there are so many other things. There is a national park which take care of these animals, the rhino, the single horned rhino. It is going to be extinct, but because of this Kaziranga National Park, these rhinos are saved, and they are safe here. They can move around safely. You can see so many single horned rhinos here in this national park. Other than the rhinos, you can see other animals also, and it is a very beautiful place to see. Then other than the tea garden, the Kaziranga National Park, the Brahmaputra River, it is the lifeline of Assam. And due to this river, the place is very much fertile. And this is also known as the place of a land of fairs and festivals. Let us see the lifestyle of the people in Assam. Here, this land is known as the land of festivals. You can see people are so happy here, and you can see the famous Bihu dance of Assam. The dressing is so simple and so colorful. So this is about Assam. Now we will see about the food of Assam. Again, the food of Assam, unlike Arunachal Pradesh, it consists of rice, vegetables and meat. A little bit difference is there. You can see the names of the dishes over here, and these are the food, the delicacies of Assam. Now we will move on to our next sister, that is Meghalaya. Meghalaya, Megh in Hindi, it means clouds. Alay means the place where we can find lots of clouds. So Meghalaya is a place where you can find lots of clouds, a place full of clouds. So we will move on. You can see here, yes, this is the waterfall, the natural beauty of Meghalaya. You can see this Meghalaya is also known as the Scotland of India. Children, you can see this boat. It is not in on the air, it is on the water. You can see the shadow of the boat inside the water. You can make out the water is so clear, so pure, so clean over here. So the natural beauty, the nature is so clean over here, and you can enjoy the natural beauty in Meghalaya very well. You can see Chirapunji. Chirapunji is a place where the highest amount of rainfall is recorded everywhere. It is situated in Meghalaya, and this is the Seven Sisters Fall. This is the biggest, largest waterfall, and it is too beautiful. Now we will move to the people in Meghalaya. You can see these are the tribals of Meghalaya, the Khasi tribe, the Garo tribe, the Nar tribe in Meghalaya. They are the dresses they are wearing, so simple, so beautiful and colorful. Now, the occupation of the people in Meghalaya. The main occupation of the people in Meghalaya is agriculture. Other than tea gardening, the people follow the occupation of agriculture, farming. They do farming other than people also work in tea gardens. They have their own tea gardens, but other than that, they agriculture is also their main occupation. Children, this was all about Meghalaya. Now we will see about the food of Meghalaya. Now here again, the food of Meghalaya is very simple, containing meat, vegetables and rice. The main food of these people contains rice, vegetables and meat, and so colorful. The food is also so colorful, no? Like the people, their dresses, their smiles, isn't it? So the people over here, they are very much overwhelming. They are hospitable, soft and beautiful people. So this was all about Meghalaya. So children, other four sisters we will see in the next part. Till then, thank you. Take care.